There. People usually bracket us in the sex part of it, because sexuality is just like a mard or mard, author or a trans. They always become like that. But then when you really break it down, love is just love. You know, that's what I'm talking about, is that we have, like, if you see Anis and Sanam's story, house hunting is a pain for all of us in Bombay, especially if you're in the fringes. So, like, to cover the story and tell it from an authentic POV, I think is genuinely what something this country needed. And I'm so glad we get to see it. JD, my next question is for you. Throughout the entire process of making the show, like, not only did we get access to the queer folks that we covered in the stories, but we also met their families and colleagues, like people who we know that might be difficult to access, you know, because it's a queer landscape. So what was the biggest challenges maneuvering this, like, entirely?
I think for this particular show, it's really interesting what it revealed, that actually the world is a nice place. We met incredible people. We met incredible families, neighbors, and Daniela's story, how Bhayandar comes together to, make that marriage happen. What was really, I think, tough for us to navigate was our gaze, which is, we have to look at characters with empathy, celebrate them, and yet, keep the authenticity. So you guys saw the second episode, and you see that fight on the terrace that Daniela and Joel have. It is very easy for us to, sort of sensationalize it or make it very, like, but that defeats the purpose, because, for me, the characters have always been superheroes. They've always been victors. So for us, managing the gaze, but honestly, if you, no pun intended. In terms of access, it has been incredible, isn't it? Like the way all the families, whether it's Anis's mother, the kind of acceptance that is there in the world that we encountered, it was a revelation. Honestly, before this, I thought that the world is a shit place. I really now, after making this show, think the world is a great place. It is. And everyone just wants to be happy and love, really. And these are not just words.
And we shot in pockets of India where one might assume that queerness might not be accepted, but it was fairly like, yeah, okay, cool. You know, I think sometimes, again, we get caught up in our cities and we're like, oh, it's a big deal. But our regular folks in our country, they just don't give a shit. They just move on. Like, pani bharna hai, kapda dhona hai, chalo, let's go.
And I really want to say this. There's constantly this thing of Western civilization. Actually, the whole 377 is the Western civilization, the Victorian laws and the colonialism.
Correct.
We are such a permissive, such a beautiful, progressive country forever. And that love exists everywhere. So, yeah.
Awesome. Thanks, JD. Samira, from Vice, we've seen several topics across the queer spectrum being covered internationally as well as in India. But what about this topic stood out for you so much that you were like, okay, we can rally behind this? The idea about queer love or associations or marriages for that matter, what stood out for you?
I mean, everything stood out because it's not being told enough. So, I mean, from the moment Vice sort of formed in India, this was one of our agendas, is to sort of normalize these conversations, build empathy, show joy instead of only showing prejudice, you know, because there are people living their lives and they're happy and they're doing things that everybody does, but we don't see that side of the queer community. It's only when things go wrong that, like, it's put out in newspapers and stuff like that. So the idea was, let's do a show that celebrates queer joy. And when we took it to Amazon, and they were like, yes, let's do it. Like, it was so amazing to find a partner that was completely on the same page as us.
Absolutely. Like, I'm a writer, so we face the most amount of feedback when we write stuff, fiction or non-fiction. But I have to give, like, hands off to, like, hats off to Prime Video. They were really, like, on board with this, like, okay, y'all are doing this, we trust your vision. And I think that was great for us to also experiment this. You know, like, for example, putting up a wedding together was the biggest daunting thing that all of us could have imagined. But we pulled it through. Bhayandar came through, as I said, and my hometown, I feel finally proud that I was from there. Otherwise, it's okay. But it's such a great feeling to have all of us rally together and make this happen. So I think it's a miracle. It's a lightning in a bottle that we've captured, and I hope everybody resonates with this when it comes down on November 7th. We'll open the floor to more questions now from all of y'all. Please, okay, sir. Do we have a mic for him? Oh, okay. They've already picked somebody, sorry.
Hi, this is
Hi.
Letty from Midday. Hi.
Hi, Letty.
My question is to Jaideep. Among the 12 that were shortlisted, besides the time constraints and the limited time that you had to fit it in, what was the reason why the other stories were not picked and these were picked? Like, why?
We had certain criteria when we were casting. One, Naveen and I were very clear from the very beginning. Naveen is also the casting director of the show. We were very clear that, you know, you see gay love stories a lot, visibly across stories, fiction, films, but you don't see trans stories. You don't see trans love stories or even lesbian love stories that much. So we wanted to cover the spectrum. And we wanted compelling stories from across the spectrum. And there's so much more to cover. Hopefully there'll be a second season and then we can feature the others.
Also, I think we looked at characters that were genuinely going through pivotal moments in their life. You know, so we had a story to tell.
Yeah.
If you want
to elaborate. No, fair. No, absolutely. And the other thing that, you know, we wanted to do is we wanted the themes to be universal. So, for example, when Anees and Sanam are looking for a home, like Naveen said, you know, anyone on the fringes who's looking for a home will relate to it. You know, whether it's a live-in couple and the society is saying, pehle shaadi ka certificate dekho, they will relate to it. So at the end of the day, we wanted themes and these moments and stories which were universal. And these six really resonated with us. And of course, they're phenomenal characters. So
Also, I think geographically, we had to like have them diverse because we were like getting a lot of stories from Bombay, Delhi, Bangalore, and we've seen those. You know what I'm saying? Like city life, I think going to Imphal for that matter, which you haven't seen yet, wait for it. So it's a gorgeous, like it's a beautiful thing to look at. And I think it's in the current time also, we have to tell stories from Manipur. We have to tell stories from Guwahati. We have to tell stories from Hampi. Small towns where we don't get to hear stories of queerness from. So I think that was a criteria where we were shortlisting. But generally, like, we didn't want to let go of anybody. We're like, so many beautiful people we've met, so many great stories that we've touched from Kashmir to Kanyakumari. But like, you know, there are certain constraints, as JD said, but then we finally got this perfect cast of six people. And I think when we got them and when we presented the stories to Amazon, we immediately all felt it. Like, there were goosebumps in the entire room. So I think that was unanimous. Yeah. Our next question?
Yeah. Coming back to the casting of Trinetra, was it done through audition or she has already done Made in Heaven season 2 like that? How was Trinetra casted?
Oh, this was cast way before David Shaw. I mean, I don't know whether Made in Heaven. No, so our casting process were generally interviews, so not auditions because they are not actors. So there were extensive interviews that Naveen did with Trinetra. And the way she spoke, she's all of 25, such an amazing, prolific doctor, actor. Like, she ticked all the boxes and she speaks so well.
We didn't know about Made in Heaven at that time.
Yeah. She's a great presence on Instagram, in the internet. Yeah. She's very inspiring.
Back then she was sharing her stories of transition and helping other trans folks come to terms with their identity. That was her Instagram, brand. And we were like, okay, we're very drawn to that personality. And then, like, I think after 2 months was when she was announced to be on the cast.
Yeah.
But by then, within the first week, we had shortlisted Trinetra and Lush because we loved them so much. They were just so genuine and so brimming with joy, you know, when we interviewed them.
We knew.
And for Amazon, November 7th, you told it's streaming, no? It's like your regular, it will be streaming in regional languages of India or whatever, how it is language.
That's right.
It's subtitles.
It's going to be all six.